Welcome to today's video. This one is all about fin plates. In this demo assembly, I want to connect the support beams to the primary structure with fin plates. To do that, we can use the gusset plate tool. With the tool activated, we first select the bolted face and then the welded face. We get a preview, but it doesn't look like how we imagined the fin plate to be. In the settings, of course, we can define all the parameters as we like. First, we add height offsets. The values refer to the height of the bolted surface and are therefore negative. The next value would be the chamfer. We don't need that here, and after that the thickness follows, which is fine at 10 mm. The bottommost value indicates where the beam is to be cut. This is the only specification where I have to do a bit of math. 164 mm in my case results in a cut with a 20 mm gap to the main beam. We could of course also select that the beam is not cut, but that would make no sense here. Here below we define our bore pattern. I'd like to have two rows, with 80 mm spacing between the rows and 40 mm to the edge, so the holes are centered. Horizontal spacing is also 80 mm, 45 mm in the front and also another 45 mm in the back. Clicking on Assemble opens the part selection, where we can define the bolting exactly as always in SolidSteel. A click on Default Mountings adds two washers and a nut to match the selected bolt standard and the clamping length. Confirm and the bolted connection will also appear in the preview. Don't forget to click on the pin before confirming. We'll see why this is important in a minute. The computer calculates for a moment in which the part and welding assembly are created, the profile is cut, holes and bolts are added, etc., and our first fin plate is finished. Well, I still have to explain why pinning is important. Quite simply, as long as the dialog remains open, all the values entered are also retained. We can now add the other fin plates with just three clicks. 1. Select the bolted surface. 2. Select the welded surface. 3. Confirm. This makes the job incredibly fast. Of course, we can also save the connection as a template and then use it again and again at any time. By the way, by pressing the D key, we can also avoid leaving the 3D window and can confirm directly in the pop-up menu after selecting the beams. Okay, now we have finished connecting the secondary beams to the primary construction. That's it for this video. If you enjoyed it, feel free to hit the like button, it would make me happy. For more information about SolidSteel, parametric and the other apps for SolidWorks, please visit our website. Thanks for watching and see you next time.